So you had a very interesting case presentation where a patient presented with chest pain for 4 hours in a setup where cath lab facility is not available. In such kind of a setup, how do we approach these patients, sir?
Okay. Actually, this patient came with a chest pain of 4 hours when admitted to our hospital without any facility or cath lab. The most important issue is that when the patient came and we saw the patient at intensive coronary care unit, the patient had minimum chest pain, the patient had the high enzyme level, but the patient was not much symptomatic. But looking at the ECG, that was very interesting and intriguing. The ECG, there was the patient ECG in the anterior leads, that V2 to V5, the patient have the symmetric, we call the Whelan syndrome. Whelan syndrome means, is a diagnosed by ECG, the patient with the prior history of chest pain, the patient has come to you without chest pain or minimum chest pain, and there is a either biphasic T wave in the anterior leads or the deep T inversion on the anterior leads, but there is no STT changes, and also there is a normal progression of ROA in the ventricular leads. What is the importance? The importance of this case is that with such ECG, about 100% of patients with such ECG finding, with the history of the prolonged chest pain, there is a critical block at the proximal part of the left anterior descending artery, and it has been shown that in spite of best medical treatment, if the patient does not undergo PCI, that is interventional management, about 75% of patients develop extensive acute anterior wall myocardial infarction with or without heart failure. So we have to recognize this sort of ECG in a such situations. Many a times we miss such patients, and apparently the patient is being taken not seriously since patient is not having much chest pain, but we don't give much importance to the ECG finding. So this is that each and every physicians who are working at the emergency level or ICU level, even cardiologists who are seeing such patients with such ECG changes, that is deep T inversion or biphasic T wave in the anterior leads with a history of chest pain, with or without rising of the high sensitivity troponin T, and the patient might have no pain or mild pain, they should be treated as a very high risk group, and he should be transferred to the PCI capable center. Actually, what I did in my patient, though the patient came from the very middle class family, the patient could not manage much money. But ideally, the patient should undergo PCI within 24 hours. But unfortunately, though we were able to transfer the patient within 72 hours and the patient was admitted to PCI capable center, when after few minutes after his admission to the PCI capable center, the patient developed chest pain, he was rushed to the cath lab, and he had a very more than 90% lesion in the proximal malady and 80% lesion at the your circumflex. The patient was successfully stented, and now the patient having no angina, his ejection fraction has improved. So patient having the pain-free and almost normal life, of course, with post-stenting medications. This is our focus. What I emphasize is that each and every patient with non-ST elevation MI with history of chest pain, this sort of ECG changes, Whelan's, we call the Whelan's phenomena, should be and must be detected on time so that patient can be benefited from the urgent PCI.
So how is the prognosis different in Whelan's syndrome than another non-STEMI patient?
In Whelan's syndrome, say a patient, in our patient, the intermediate group by the risk criteria, GRACE or the TME risk criteria, but from the valence phenomena, the patient was in high risk. If the patient is not, as I mentioned earlier, the 75% of patients who are treated only medically, they are prone to develop acute myocardial infarction within 7 to 10 days. A non-STEMI patient without much such clinical history but without any valence phenomena, they can be managed medically. But if we detect valence, they should be referred to PCI, or if the patient is admitted to PCI capable center, then he should undergo immediate coronary angiography and necessary PCI to avoid the impending acute myocardial infarction. So the prognosis depends. If there is a valence syndrome, then if the patient does not have the benefit of the PCI, the patient, most of the patient, two-thirds of the patient, more than two-thirds of the patient, they will go for the anterior wall infarction. But patient without valence phenomena, they won't have such fate. But they may have the other major cardiac events, but not the acute myocardial infarction.
So what will be your last message to the large number of physicians and cardiologists who may be the first point of contact for such patients?
First is the proper clinical examination, and each you have to, the all the physicians working at the emergency or the intensive coronary care, say very meticulously look at the ECG of the patient. They take the detailed history, whether they have any features of chest pain with perspiration or syncope, all these things. So if you don't go through the only T inversion, so the patient is having the only non-STEMI, same the patient will end up in a severe acute myocardial infarction. So each and every first contact doctor should learn this, what is valence phenomena, and they accordingly they plan and the strategy for managing this patient. The strategy is only one, for referring the patient or sending the patient for urgent PCI.